In this video tutorial series, we're going to be discussing the picture response example. Before we get into the details of this particular example, we should first become familiar with the Experiment Builder user interface. On the right side of the interface is the Graph Editor window. Above the Graph Editor window is the Experiment Component panel. The Component panel is divided into three sections: Action, Trigger, and Other. Each section contains several different components, or nodes, that can be added to the Graph Editor window to create the experimental flow and implement the intended experimental design. The nodes in the Action section perform some kind of action when encountered in the experimental flow. For example, the Display Screen action can be used to present visual stimuli to the Display PC monitor. The details of all these nodes is not so important at this point, but note that you can use actions to do things like put the system into camera setup mode, do a drift check or drift correction between trials or blocks, or play or record audio. The nodes in the trigger section wait for a particular type of event to occur before allowing the experimental flow to proceed. For example, the keyboard trigger waits for input on a keyboard before allowing the flow to proceed. The mouse trigger waits for a mouse click, and you can specify a triggering region for this click if desired. Note there are also some eye-based triggers that fire based on eye movements, but these won't be used in the current example. The most commonly used node in the Other section is the Variable node. This type of node does not connect to actions and triggers, but instead just kind of floats out there in the Graph Editor window by itself. Variable nodes can be used in lots of different ways, but they are commonly used to keep track of behavioral measures like reaction times and accuracies. On the left side of the interface, there are several panels. The Overview panel allows you to quickly move around in the Graph Editor window. The Structure panel provides a hierarchical representation of the project that provides an alternative way to access the different components of the project. The Structure panel also contains a Devices tab. When you go to the Devices tab, you're presented with all the hardware settings of the project. To change the settings of a given piece of hardware, simply navigate to its subsection in the Devices section and edit the properties below. The Properties panel shows the properties of whatever node or resource is currently selected. Properties that are not grayed out can be edited through the Properties panel. Finally, the Notes panel allows you to record notes for each node for record keeping or instructional purposes.